everybody, welcome back to Wine Up TV. I'm your host Wayne. On today's show, three outstanding wines, one from Monterey County in California, Chardonnay. Love the style. A great wine from Washington State. This is a Le Col Syrah, and of course, one of my favorite countries that makes Shiraz is Australia. When we come back, we're going to taste these three. See you in a second. First wine we're going to have today is a Cali Heart Chardonnay. But before I start talking about these wines, I went to this amazing tasting at a local distributor here last Monday, and it was just fantastic. I mean, there's probably 150 wines, about 350 people. It was rocking. Bob and Matt, you did a great job. Thank you very much for hosting it. And these are some of the wines, actually, that I had the privilege of tasting. So the first wine is a Cali Heart Chardonnay from Monterey County, California. Monterey County, back in the 70s, planted a lot of stuff, Chardonnay, Cabernet, even Merlot, and it was just too cool. Even though it was a lot of sunny days, it wasn't warm enough to ripen like Cabernet and Chardonnay, or excuse me, Cabernet and Merlot very well. And so you had a lot of these herbaceous green bell pepper flavors in those wines, but they've dialed it in on the Chardonnay. And this first wine is a Cali Heart Chardonnay. This comes from Monterey County. It is $15 a bottle, and one nice thing about this wine that I noticed when I had it was the nose. And let's get this little smell. Very, very Californian. It's got a little bit of ML, but it's got really like the mango and the pineapple action going on in a Chardonnay. Very, very well structured. The color on this is beautiful. Golden straw. This is the 2008 vintage, a little bit cool down there. This is not a purist Chardonnay by any means. I like it. It's a little sweet. It's got about 0.7% residual sugar. Kind of like how Jet Steel made Kendall Jackson Chardonnay back in the 80s and early 90s. A little bit of residual sugar really gained a popularity. This wine here, it's got mango, got some pineapple going on. It's really nice, good acidity, nice long finish. That extra aging in new French oak, you can really taste that on the palate. It's a nice little wine for $15. And it's something that if you don't like Chardonnay completely dry, some people like kind of sweeter wines, this may be a go-to wine for you. It's very interesting. I had the 2009, not anything like the 2008. Two different winemakers. The 09 is going to be a lot more dry and a little bit more structured. But I really, you know, for the money, this is definitely a nice little wine. All right, so next wine we're going to talk about. Back in 1988, I went through Walla Walla before it was even popular. And I remember vividly meeting Rick Small at Woodward Canyon, Gary Figgins at Lynette, and, you know, I can't remember the gentleman I met at Le Col, but I stopped by this little schoolhouse and I thought, what a cool little schoolhouse, Le Col number 41. And I had their wines, some of the 86s, 85s I had back in the day, and they were wonderful. Well, I've been following them all along. Thank goodness I'm blessed to be able to do what I'm doing now and being able to carry these wonderful wines in the shop. So anyway, this is the 2007 Columbia Valley Syrah. It's about 93% Syrah, 7% Grenache. It's $21 a bottle. And just the color and the structure of these wines are just phenomenal. This wine here, look at that dark black fruit colors. And just amazing. They do a lot of wines. They get real good accolades from the Wine Spectator. I think this wine here actually got a 90 or 91 from the Wine Spectator. But just aside from the scores, these wines are structurally sound. And the fruit comes from Columbia Valley, Walla Walla, all back in eastern Washington, southeastern Washington. So it's just great. So let's get this little smell. Real robust. It's got kind of leather and jammy. It's got like roasted grilled meat, which is very typical for a Syrah, actually. blackberry, some blueberry tones, some nice vanilla overtones, and of course, a little bit of subtle oak. God, I just, there's nothing about these Washington wines I don't like. They're really structured, I love them. Let's give this a little taste. God, it just makes my mouth water. Jammy, just a real fruity wine. Fruity in a dry sense, so you get your black cherry fruits, you have your blueberry fruits, some just black cherry going on. A lot's happening, and it's got nice, soft, silky tannins, so it's not really over the top, so to speak, but it's really got that length and depth and breadth with it. It's just beautiful wine. Might want to decant this thing for about a half an hour. I generally don't open my wines more than, you know, half an hour or 10, 15 minutes before I shoot my shows, which I should decant some of these, but I don't. However, that's a very good effort right there. Now, let's get on to this next wine. People always ask me what kind of wines I like. I love Shirazes from Australia. They tend to be a little bit higher in alcohol, but I just love the jamminess and the fruit characteristics of Australian wine, especially at Barossa Valley Shiraz. This is a McLaren Vale Shiraz. This happens to be $20 a bottle, and it's 95% Shiraz, 5% Viognier, very traditional Rhone blend, blending some of that Viognier in it, add some aromatics to it, soften it up just a little bit. But look at the color of this. This is a 2007. Just a beautiful, it's kind of like, it's a brickish red on the tint of it, but it's got that nice depth and nice deep. Man, let's get into this wine. This is real meaty. You know, this one here is a little kind of meaty. This is really meaty. And when I mean like grilled roasted meats, it's got that burned characteristic to it, all in a good way. A little tar, a little tobacco on the nose. Wow. Let's give this a little taste. It's not as big and bold as the Lacole, but it's got a nice character, nice quality to it. It's jammy, yet elegant. Not a lot of acidity, but a real nice long finish. This is a decent effort. $20, the Wira Wira, the Catapult, McLaren Vale. Very nice wine. And at $20 a bottle, I think it's a pretty decent value at that. Yum. Well, today, three different wines. Nice Chardonnay, beautifully structured Syrah from Walla Walla, Columbia Valley, beautiful up there. And then the Wira Wira McLaren Vale Shiraz right here. Everybody, thank you very much for tuning in. On tomorrow's show, we're going to have three more great wines. So remember, every day, a couple of great glasses of wine. And if you're ever in the Willamette Valley, I will give you a tour like nobody else can ever give. Thank you very much for tuning in. Tell your friends, wineuptv.com, and also friend me up on Facebook at Wayne Wine Wizard. Thanks and have a great day.